not get too tilted right now. Just gotta take a breath. Take it nice and slow. Ooh! Smooth.
Over time, we've poured more and more refuse into this vast digital landfill that we call the internet. It now vastly outnumbers and outweighs the things that are fresh and untainted and unused. When everything around us is cultural trash, trash becomes the new medium, the lingua franca of the digital age. And you can build culture out of trash. But only trash culture. Be games, be movies, be music, be philosophy. Maybe this is what digital culture is. A monstrous mountain of trash, the ash heap of creativity's fountain. A landfill with everything we ever thought of in it. Grand, infinite, and unsorted.
Well, I did not expect for me to get this far.
There's 3D models of breakfast, Gen X's fanfic novels, scan magazines, green screen Shia LaBeouf, banned stuff scenes on LiveLeak, Facebook's got lifelike bots, unbranded adverts and candid shots of Kanye and Taylor Swift mashups, car crash epic failed GIFs, Russian dashcam vids, discussions of McRibs, discarded, forgotten, unrecycled, muddled, rotten, untitled.
Everything he just said blasted me with a heavy wave of nostalgia. Anyways. Oh no! Oh my god. Well, yeah, we kind of walked around. I walked around. Sean played Clash Royale, and Aiden went to use the bathroom? I'm not sure. I think he did, and after that we walked around together. We ended up sitting right by Pirate's Cove, which wasn't a cove. Actually, I think it was a cove. Yeah, it was a cove. But the main part of Pirate's Cove was the huge jagged rock. Rocks, I guess. It was a huge sort of like mini hill.
Everything's fresh for about 6 seconds, until some newer thing beckons, and we hit refresh. And there's years of persevering, disappearing into the pile, out of style, out of sight.
Sat by, and there was the top, and there were signs of no climbing and all that everywhere. Okay, my heart stopped, which is not good, right? But there were signs of no climbing littered across Pirate's Cove, yet in the sunset, we saw 3 kids racing up the sharpest rocks of Pirate's Cove.
In this context, it's tempting to make friendly content that's gentle, that lets you churn through it but not earn it. Why make something demanding if it just gets piled up in the landfill, filed in with the bland things?
We saw these kids, I think it was 4 kids, they raced to the top of Pirate's Cove. A good few yards from, I think it was like 5 yards from like the nearest sort of flat surface. Yeah, it was pretty high up. And to someone who is afraid of heights and getting hurt, that was terrifying. Not necessarily because I was, you know, afraid of what happened to the kids, but I was terrified of what the kids' perspective would be. They weren't scared, however, as people started yelling, like, get down or be careful. Their parents soon came, told them to get down safely. 3 of them ran, and the other one jumped. Jumped isn't the right word. Neither does that sound great, right? They wouldn't jump like good 5 yards down, break their leg, possibly die. The last kid sort of just like dropped from smaller sort of separate shards of the huge cove and eventually landed. Not landed, sorry. Eventually got down. Uh-oh. Oh. Sure when the music will stop, and I really hope this isn't copyrighted. I don't think it's gonna stop anytime soon, so I'll just talk over it. Yeah, they all ended up going, and by the time they were all down, it was really dark, right? The last few minutes of sunshine before everything just sort of died. This is the sort of really made it memorable. We got to sort of make our own hot dogs. It was pretty cool. Never got to do it before, and I was excited. Okay. I don't know why I did that. It was very exciting. I thought... Because I'm like, wow, I never got to do this. Time comes, we see some kid, actually I never really saw the kid, but we saw what the kid did. He dropped his hot dog in the sand, right? And it was one of those wet, like packeted, like, hot dogs, so it had, like, all the hot dog juice on it, and it was quite disgusting. It was quite putrid. It reeked. I don't know how. It smelled of sewer, like sewage. But we were given sort of skewers to sort of roast the hot dogs. And Aiden finished his hot dog because he was starving, apparently, and he raced to get his hot dog. And I'm like, yo, Aiden, check this out. I still had my hot dog, and he's like, what? And I'm like, dude, look at that hot dog. And he's like, that's a hot dog? It was much more funny in person. But he's like, yo, hold on, Kevin, look at this. And he, like, picked it up and, like, put on a skewer. And then he went over to the fire pit where, you know, you would roast your hot dog. Yeah.
When games were new, they wanted a lot from you. Daunting you, taunting you, resetting and delaying you. Players played stoically. Now everyone's turned off by that. They want to burn through it quickly. A quick fix for the fickle. Some tricks for the clicks of the feckless. But that's not you. You're an acrobat. You could swallow a baseball bat.
Right, but Aiden then continued to really roast the sand hot dog. The sand weenie. And at that point, it was pretty disgusting. He ended up dropping his skewer, and the hot dog, the sand weenie, got set on fire and was covered in ash. Right, and we're like, all right, that's it's toast, yeah. It's there's no recovering from that. It's gone. And out of the blue, some kid went, that's my hot dog. And he went, guys, hold on. And he used his skewer and fished out the deaf weenie. And he then continued to roast it. Well done. It was pretty much half the size as it was before Aiden dropped it into the fire. And he said, perfect. Right? He went over. And the whole station was set up like this. Let me explain. They would give you a skewer on the hot dog. You would go roast it. And you would come back, get a bun. Right? Get your hot dog bun. And you could put condiments on it. This kid ran back with that thing. And the two the word is escaping me at the moment. The two volunteers, two volunteers at the station, they were shocked. One of them said Dios míos, which is oh my god in Spanish. And the other one was just silent. Right? It was hella funny. More terrifying than funny, but funny regardless. But it was funny regardless.
Now I know, most likely you're watching this on YouTube or Twitch, while some dude with 10 million views does it for you. Like a baby bird being fed chewed up food. That's culture too.
Anyways, yeah, they were disgusted and told the kid to get another one. But the kid said, I don't want that. I don't want another one. And I wanted this one. And he continued to throw a huge fit. Right? It was quite spectacular, actually. I've never seen someone throw a fit over a burnt, sanded hot dog, but it happened. They ended up letting the kid keep the hot dog, but didn't give him a bun. But he got to use the condiments, which I guess was what he wanted, because he didn't complain after that. He put relish on it, and I've never tried relish, but I don't know, the thought of relish kind of disgusts me. I can't explain why. It just kind of does.
The soul would have no rainbow had the eyes no tears. John Vance Cheney.
Oh, we're back here. Alright. Fair enough. My hands are sweating a lot. You guys don't know that, but they are.
The pain.
Oh no!